Hello Aries and welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are having a great day today. So let's see what's going on around you in love, what spirit wants you to know. Just take what resonates, leave the rest behind. When are they gonna boss up, right? I feel like you've been the strong one. Here's the thing, you know, I'm really feeling like you're the one showing all the strength, and there's a person here that it's like they don't, it's like they've been kind of a coward. I want to say a coward. They've been lazy. They've been procrastinating. They've been, and you just want the truth. You want some kind of apology. You want to know what the heck is going on. I feel it's more like you're saying, when are you going to stand up, take a stand for yourself, show some strength and boss up into an emperor? When are you going to do that? You know, you're not talking to anybody, but you're like thinking it, okay? You know, because you've been the one showing all of the strength. You're thinking to yourself, is it so dang hard to be honest? Is it so hard to give someone an apology? I've shown nothing but strength. This is what you're saying. I've shown nothing but strength and integrity. And you can't even get up and take a stand? I feel like this person, I feel like they've been avoiding this. They've been possibly too afraid to come forward because they're not in Emperor energy yet. You're wondering, are they ever going to get there, right? Yeah, clap, clap if I'm, yeah. But somebody's trying to put on their makeup while they're watching this and you're having to put down your mascara and clap your hands. Yeah, if that's a big confirmation, okay? Big confirmation that this is for you. You could be a Leo. You could be a Libra, Gemini, Aquarius. Yeah, they're totally ruining their wish fulfillment here. This person, if they were to boss up into their emperor status, right? If they were to get that strength, show a backbone, have some courage, okay? They could have possibly had the Ten of Cups with you. That's an ultimate wish fulfilled life. That's having the kind of life everybody dreams of having. All of this happiness, love, happy family, happy kids, beautiful home. They could have had it all. Emotional fulfillment. But instead, this person is laying here in this pain. And here's the thing, you know this. You're not even a part of, like, they booted you out of their life. They Three of Swords to you. This person broke your heart and put you in a third-party situation. Chose someone else over you, and you want answers. You want to know why. Why did this happen? Are you going to give me an apology? You want justice. You want justice. And here's the thing, it makes no sense. Not only are you the strongest one between the two, okay, this person showing no courage, you know, not only are you the strongest one, you've got the most integrity here as well, okay, but you're, what was I going to say? Not only are you the strongest one. Yeah, maybe that was it. But you've got the integrity and you've got common sense. That's what I wanted to talk about. You've got common sense. Like you're sitting here thinking to yourself, there's no sense to this. This person is kind of, you know, they're in a lot of pain without you. They're suffering karma for the things that they've done. They're kind of a complete wreck right now. Okay, and they're doing this to themselves. It makes no sense. Not only are you the strongest one, but you're also the only voice of reason here. You know, they're only hurting themselves. Really? And you don't understand why it's so hard for this person to just speak the truth. Why is it so hard? Nothing's going right in their life. Look, this, they could have had a celebration here. They could have had wish fulfillment. But this is coming out on its side. they're not getting the celebration. They're only, it's like they keep sticking a sword in their own back. And meanwhile, all this person can do is think about you, look for you everywhere they go. You could be a Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. They could be a possibly a Virgo. Feel like all this person does is think about you and think about what they've done. I feel like they're acting like a coward, you know, and you just want them to show some strength and some courage, right? I feel like, yeah, they're having this tower moment. They're seeing you either having a new beginning, they're seeing you succeeding, they're seeing you maybe even turning your back on them. They could be seeing someone else come into the picture as well. Okay, they're watching you like a hawk. I feel like they're seeing a lot. They know that you're, I feel like they know that, yeah, and new love is here. Yeah, they know that you're moving on. And it's giving them a tower moment. You could be dealing with an Aquarius, possibly a Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, maybe a Leo. You could have posted something on the internet as well. Like if you've recently met someone, you could have posted something about it or posted something about being asked out on a date. Yeah, I'm getting that you're over this person. Yep. You're not speaking to them. You may have this person blocked on your phone. If you think you have this person blocked on social media, they can still see you, you know. They're probably using like a fake profile, okay? I feel like they're watching everything that you do. Look at them. Day, night. For real. This person's watching you 24/7. Anything that you put out on your social media, or if you have any kind of website, or it could be anywhere on the internet, they're able to see it. You may think that they can't, but they can. And they know that you're manifesting someone new. They know that you've healed from this connection. They know that door is closing. They can see you getting some blessings happening to you in your life. They're following your life. Okay, they are. They're totally following your life. Like this is kind of like your biggest fan, but they're not even reaching for the sword here. They keep putting off communication with you. Okay? 'Cause they know they've done a lot to hurt you. Yeah, they see you bossing up into the Empress. So they're watching you from afar, completely silent, possibly wanting to come in, maybe wanting to come and communicate. I don't know. I feel like spirit is like, you know what, collective, cut them off. I feel like spirit doesn't want this person back in. It's coming on top of the Wheel of Fortune. This to me is like an open door, right? But it's like a that door is closing on this person. Like it's the end to a cycle and they can't come back in. Spirit doesn't want them back in. Spirit doesn't want them back in with this Ace of Swords out here. Because I feel like this person just, they keep avoiding contact with you. They keep avoiding communicating. They haven't bossed up into the Emperor yet. They're still very cowardly. Watching you know, keeping their moves hidden. And spirit is like, you know what, enough. It's the end to a cycle. They can't come back in. Yeah. And I feel like even if, yeah, they're missing out on an opportunity here, clearly, because all they did was ignore the situation. But even if they do come in with an apology, I don't even think, maybe you don't even want to hear it anymore. This kind of feels like a shift because for the longest time, you're like, how hard can it be? How hard can it be for somebody to come in and say, I'm sorry. I'm sorry I wronged you. How hard can it be for this person to have a little bit of courage? You know, all you wanted was the truth. This person owed you the truth and an explanation. And now it's like, it's down to the point where you're just done. You know, you've grown here. You've handled this with nothing but integrity and honesty. You were nothing but patient. And you've grown into the Empress. So you're attracting someone new towards you already, okay? If you haven't already met someone new, because you may have. You may have. And I feel like Spirit is like, I feel like Spirit is severing this connection. If this was a twin flame, I feel like the divine is severing it. Because this person just didn't show you anything. They didn't, yes. And as I say that, see, it's because it's coming out with the sword. And it's God that's holding the sword in his hand. And I feel like there's a separation. Okay, so at the end of this cycle with the Wheel of Fortune, the cycle closes out. Spirit picks up this big sword, cuts that cord. I feel like it's done. And I feel like as they do that, someone new is ushered in for you. You're already attracting. Yeah, and your person can feel that. Ooh, but so can you. So can you. It's making you, look, they're in the nut. As soon as Spirit severs this connection, they feel that pain and heartache, panic, anxiety, fear, and you feel free. Okay? You feel free. And you feel comfortable because you're able to love yourself, you know? And I feel like all you need is one more cup to wish fulfillment, and you're about to get that. So now you're going to be in the Ten of Cups anyway. You're going to be blessed, and this person, they're ending up in the Ten of Swords. It's right here, central focus, the Ten of Swords, when they could have had the Ten of Cups. Okay? I kid you not. I cannot make it up. They could have been with you. They could have had this, the Ten of Cups. But instead, Spirit is disconnecting this. The Spirit is severing this connection, and they're ending up in the Ten of Swords instead. Yeah, I feel like Spirit is deeming this person unworthy of you. They may have been a divine masculine, but now I feel like they're being stripped of everything, the title, their blessings. They're feeling this severing of this connection. Yeah, yes, oh, they're feeling it hardcore. Because they're feeling very out in the cold. They're feeling very left behind. Left behind, not just by you now. But I feel like Spirit is kind of saying, you know, we're trying to work with you on this and you're not listening, so we're done with that too. No, I feel like they're not getting any divine intervention. This person could be losing their health, losing their money. Possibly even ending up losing a home. They've got a lot of burdens, a lot of worries and fears right now. They can totally feel that this is somebody who is now a fallen one. Okay? Now they're a fallen one. Yeah, you're about to get someone new. You're about to get in a commitment with someone else on the Ten of Pentacles. See, this is what they could have had with you. They could have had the Ten of Cups and the Ten of Pentacles, the two best cards in the deck. But instead, they've got the Ten of Swords and the Five of Pentacles, okay? So they're struggling financially. Yeah, this person manipulated you. They've juggled you in the past with other people. I feel like now they're starting to lose even more abundance. Like, they're losing pentacles really quickly. Okay? So they're gonna end up broke. Yeah, they're trying to hold on to whatever little bit they've got. And I feel like they're also hanging on to their ego. This is why this person, I feel like it was in part ego that held them back. Okay? All they're gonna have left with is their ego. And they're gonna have to watch you. Yes, and that's the truth. They're gonna have to watch you move on to new love, commitment, a lot of money and abundance, a lot of success as well. You could end up living a very lavish lifestyle. This is what's coming for you in the future. Okay, look at that. A big castle of a home, a happy family, generational wealth, a commitment that's with somebody who's going to be at your side, wish fulfillment, Empress energy, and they're going to end up really with nothing. I mean, they really are. Yeah. You could be dealing with a Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. This person's going to be very emotional. They already are very emotional. I mean, this is someone really going through it with the Nine of Swords and the King of Cups energy. This is somebody who they're going to end up an emotional basket case. Yeah, Ten of Swords energy. Because they're realizing what they missed. You know, and now it's like they want the one person they can't have. Oh, they're gonna feel the pain of this connection being severed. You know, it could even be you trying to do a cord cutting, but I will tell you, I feel like only the divine can sever a twin flame connection. And I feel like that's what spirit is doing here, holding this big Ace of Swords to the twin flame connection. Okay? Yeah. This person has fallen from grace, collective. I want to look at their emotions, okay? What can you show me? Yep, and I even just saw it here on the bottom of the deck. Hold on a second. Let me see if I can find it. Where was it? Yeah, that was what I saw. That broken trust. This is that broken connection. This is that severed connection right there. All right, what else can you show me? And this person knows that you're getting new love or that you're about to. They could be driving past your house, driving past your car or your work. Yeah, look, and this is what this person put you through. It was very publicly humiliating. Okay, this person left you feeling like, you know, maybe it was something you did, or they left you feeling like maybe you weren't good enough, okay? Other people, I feel, talked about you, ruined your reputation over this. I feel like it was a third-party situation and this person let you have the blame. I feel like you were innocent in this. No one came to your side to help you. You know, I feel like you've lost a lot of people that you genuinely loved because of all of this. And I feel like this is the person who should have taken accountability but never did. And that's why spirit is severing this connection. Okay, but I feel like now you've accomplished a lot. You've reinvented yourself. You've gone through a transformation, especially in Empress energy. You know, and you're the one who's having the major victory here. Okay, because you've healed on your own and you're now abundant and successful and strong enough to move forward to get the kind of love that you deserve. Okay? You're being blessed here as well. Spirit is seeing everything that this person has done to you. Hold on, I need to turn on my little heater. It's super cold in Wisconsin today, okay? Yeah, look at you. You could be a Virgo. You're blessed here. A lot of abundance. I feel like right now it may feel like a lucky time in your life, like some good things are starting to happen for you, okay? Little things, big things. And I feel like one of them is going to be love. You're about to get new love, collective. And this person from your past, look, this is what they're thinking about. All of this is what they're thinking about. And they can feel that disconnect. They can feel this connection being severed. Okay? This is a contract that's being ended, nullified. That's basically what this is. And they're feeling very incomplete and pushed out, energetically in their soul. They may not even understand why. They may not understand why they're feeling this, like, where am I to go now kind of energy, right? Because this was their path. And now spirit, cut that cord and set them free. And now they're just kind of like without any kind of direction. They're feeling very lost. They're feeling lost. But they are kind of, they're not spiritually lost, but they're definitely being cut from a cord that they've had attached to them lifetime after lifetime after lifetime. And they just didn't realize it. That cord, that connection between you two in a twin flame soulmate connection, it's there. And now without it, they feel lost, without purposeless. That's what this is. Without a purpose. They feel incomplete because they ignored their purpose here. And I feel like you're happy. They're not. They hate it where they are. They're not vibing at other people's levels because they're a divine being. They were supposed to vibe higher. They were supposed to reach for something better. They were supposed to get on their path and do the right thing. And they didn't. But they still feel like they don't fit in where they are. They don't. I ain't got a home. I ain't got a friend. That's what I just heard. Yeah, they feel like they don't have a home. They don't have a place. They don't have a purpose. They feel incomplete. Okay. Yeah, and look, all of a sudden they curl up in a little ball and cry. They're feeling heartbroken. This is a divine masculine that's being released from this contract. And they don't know where to go or what to do. They may not understand why they feel that way, but this is how they feel. That's going to last. It's going to have lasting effects on this person's life. All because they avoided doing the right thing. And still, I feel like still you're like, well, how can it be so hard to actually say I'm sorry? You're still the voice of reason. It makes no common sense, and that's another reason why you have healed from this and you're able to move on without feeling a ton of heartbreak is because it just makes no sense. They lost all of this because they didn't want to apologize. I hate to say it, but that's really too bad for them.